So hey guys, today we're gonna do unboxing of the LG 34UM61. That's a 34 inches ultra wide 24:9 ratio. This is an IPS panel and that has a 60 hertz to 75 hertz refresh rate with a resolution of 2590 times 1080. So let's get started and open the box. Wow, that's really huge. That looks like almost like a table, 34 inches. Alright, let's take this out first. Oh, that's not so heavy. It's probably about 15 pounds or less. So what's in here more? Let's see. Okay, so that's the stem on the bottom. And some manuals here that you can find. So okay, it shows you how to like take it out, handling. Don't press on the screen monitor or it's gonna break. You have the picture. And what do you have in here? So what we have is the power connector to it. And that connects to this one. So, and I don't know what is this. This is the HDMI cable. Right. So it has all the instructions here. If you have time, PC in, okay, plug it in. Right, let's jump and a CD too. Wow, there's no plastic, so that can scratch easily if you know you don't store it in a safe place. What we have, that's the neck of this stand, so I'm gonna remove this. That's it. Alright. It has like thin plastic on it. This is like plastic. Looks like it's cheaply made, but it's light, which is good. That's the base. Let's remove it. So probably it's connected like this. You can screw it so it goes on top like this. Right, just fits right in. And then lock and release. So there's a lock and release here handle. You can twist it so you don't need a screwdriver. Tighten it. Okay, so you can feel it's tight in. It brings the two pieces together. Right. Okay. So we're gonna put it on my desk here, my new desk. I'm gonna connect it to my laptop later. Let's bring the panels. Remove So be careful to not like press on the pixels on the monitor itself. Otherwise you're gonna have dead pixel. Okay. So let's lay on this. Let's put this on here. So on the back of the monitor, there's two HDMI in cable. There's a headphone jack and the power adapter. And then that's it. This is gonna go to the mount, the 34UM61P. It accepts a 19 volt with 2 amps power source. And let's put it on the stand. We're gonna lay flat the monitor, and then as you can see here, there's some holes where it is for putting the stand. So it's easier you put it this way instead of like putting the stand up and putting the monitor on later on. Okay, you can hear a click, so it's on. Then we're gonna take it on the desk here. Wow, that's a really huge monitor. Wow, so you can tilt this. That's a really huge monitor. Look at the width of my window. That's almost as big as my window. Know how big it is? The LG 34 inches. This is an A4 paper. So let's measure it up. That's 1, 2, almost 3 A4 paper in length here. And then let's measure how long is this. It looks quite pretty long for me. Like, wow. So it's 32 inches and a half in long, in length. So, and what's the height of it? Like 14 inches and a half. So 14 inches and a half and 32 inches in half in length. That's, whoa, really big. This is 34 inches. Look at how slim it is. Back. Connect the cables, the power cable. Let's put it here. HDMI cable. HDMI cable. That goes into your computer or your source, video source. And this one. This is probably for cable later. That's the HDMI cable. And that's the power. So I have like an outlet here you can connect. So let's make this longer a little bit. Connect the power. So this will go in. Like this, okay. Then we're gonna connect the back to the back of the monitor. So let's find here, that's the back. Okay. It's in. right? Then next, let's connect the HDMI cable. HDMI cable that goes to your computer. Then I would let's get the cable, HDMI cable, and plug it in your laptop. Here, power it on. Wow, that's the display right here. My cousin took this picture of Seattle. But yeah, wow, that's a big display. If you look at resolution, I don't know if you can see it, you can see the text here. You can see it's pixelized, it's like really sit close to it. Do a blur test, that's a UFO blur test. So we compare multiple frame rate. If using a 120Hz monitor, then 120 frame per second is automatically added to this test. 30 FPS versus 60 FPS versus 120. So this is 30 FPS and that's 60 FPS. So this is a test to show you what's the refresh rate on here. So you can split two screens right here and then still have a decent viewing. So pretty big for the space, you can have two. And let's use the on-screen splitting. Reader, photo, cinema, FPS1, FPS2, RTS, custom game. Okay, I'm gonna do kind of like custom. First one. Let's do this. The brightness is at 100%, so contrast. Oh, look at the text. It's pretty pixelated. You can see the pixels. Volume. I didn't put any speaker on it. I didn't put any check, audio check. Picture mode. General. Power LED on or off. I don't see any changes. Picture game adjust. Black stabilizer, response time, FreeSync on. If you have this problem where you press on the FreeSync and then your LG 34 inches monitor keeps flickering like this, and how to get out of it? You see it blinks. It flickers. Okay, then the monitor start flickering like this and you cannot get out of it, can't do anything. Even if you unplug it, unplug the power and everything, wait for a moment, unplug it back in. Actually, if you press on here, you can't even set the menu because it's grayed out, so you cannot reset the FreeSync to off. That's a FreeSync that makes it flickering on the Mac here. So if you plug it back in to the Mac or to your computer, and FreeSync is still on because it retains the settings that you set FreeSync. So you cannot get out of this. So what do you do? So you can go and install on-screen control, which is from LG. After you install, you will have to restart. So FreeSync, you have to go to game mode settings. Then there's a FreeSync here, right? You'll reset it back to off. Then your monitor comes back on, right? Because FreeSync is off now. So the only way to do that is to download the LG software and control your FreeSync from here to make it off. All right, if you guys face any problem like this, that's the solution to it. If you like it, give a thumbs up. On this is 2560x1080. And that's pretty pixelated, as you can see. You can see like lines of pixels on here. So it's for reading, it's not that great. So this is a video on YouTube on this, and it's okay, but I think if you look at the text, it might be pretty pixelized. If you look up closer, you can see it's pixelized, right? So this is running on 720 resolution for the video, and the monitor is 2590x1080p. So you can see there's white bars here because it's really wide. See, it's pretty pixelized. The video is okay, but the text is pretty pixelized. So you can do side by side on two. Right. Can't even do the split on here. Which smart saving energy is low, high. Power LED, it's on. Automatic standby. Picture mode, I'm gonna put custom so we can adjust black stabilizer. Custom reader, photo, cinema, FPS 1, 2, on screen control, you can do split on screen automatically, and it's gonna split, so you could be editing and then writing words, document. Can be reading on the internet. You can run through the different split screen. The on-screen control, if it's set to 4 on the screen, so when you move over, it's gonna show the green border, that means it's gonna magnet to that. So if you move it down, okay, so you can put 4, or you can change a screen control to a different screen split here. You can do portrait, that's in half, okay. So let's do a Microsoft Word test here. You can see. Now we're gonna do a side viewing angle. You can still see it. Opposite side. but the colors kind of change a little bit when you cut. So the black is not so bad. It's kind of a little bit gray, I would say. The contrast. So this is Battlefield 1. For gaming, it's not that bad. You have that extra viewing angle. So this is a Battlefront. Battlefront. So the black is not so black. It's okay, decent. I would say if I were to change the picture mode to like really bright, then you can actually see the turn and the detail a little bit more, because then we have settings to contrast 100 and brightness 100. Yeah, so it's pretty fast, the refresh rate. This is Watch Dogs. You can see it's not widescreen, so you have that black bar on both sides. Okay. Resolution is alright. Yeah, it looks kind of like pale, a little bit, the color. Here. Sonic's, the color is a little bit not saturated. I think it doesn't pop as good. GTA 5 on the LG 34 inches. So the widescreen, you can see like a lot of it, a lot of so this is a movie trailer on it, widescreen, so you can see it's pretty good if you like sit back here and enjoy the movie. It's pretty good cinematic. I like the widescreen. Pretty cool. You can see it's pretty much okay to watch movie, but except for text, you see. So if you go on the site, you can still see it, right? But the best thing is to sit in the front, in the middle, center of the screen. You can see the detail. You sit really close. See the black, it's not as black. You can see some backlight right here. Backlight on the side. You can only see backlight if it's really dark. You see, it's bleeding. So this is After Effects on the LG 34 inches screen. So you can see the timeline. It's good to have this space, extra space on the side where you can put your extra windows on the side. So you see, perfect for editing. So you see. So you sit back here, you can't really like, it's a good decent quality when you watch the movie, but when you sit up close, like when you're working on a computer, it's kind of like really pixelated. If you do graphics or video, graphics is pixelated, but I think video must be. You can have two videos side by side and you can see it's pretty good for multitasking or for like viewing. So now we're testing the Excel spreadsheet on the LG 34 inches. So this is great when you have white screen. You can like have, you don't have to scroll. You can just like see the whole data in just one view. See that? Wow. She's nice. You don't have to scroll anymore. Regular screen would be like around here. Can see more data. Nice.
So thanks for watching my reviews. If you like it, give a thumbs up and subscribe and click that bell icon so you get further notifications of new reviews in the future.